फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम बैक टू माई यूट्यूब चैनल एस के क्लासेस. ओके, टुडे विल सी इन डिटेल अबाउट द डायहाइब्रिड क्रॉस. यस, सो एज यू नो दैट डाई स्टैंड फॉर टू. यस, सो हियर टू पेयर ऑफ कॉन्ट्रास्टिंग कैरेक्टर्स आर देयर. नाउ सी व्हाट इज डायहाइब्रिड क्रॉस. यस, अ क्रॉस बिटवीन टू प्योर होमोजाइगस पेरेंट्स इन विच द इनहेरिटेंस पैटर्न ऑफ टू पेयर ऑफ कॉन्ट्रास्टिंग कैरेक्टर इज कंसिडर्ड साइमल्टेनियसली इज कॉल्ड डायहाइब्रिड क्रॉस. ओके, सो हियर टू प्योर पेरेंट्स, होमो स्टैंड फॉर सेम, जाइगस गैमेट, दे हैव द सेम टाइप ऑफ गैमेट्स. ओके, सो दैट इज प्योर पेरेंट्स. ओके, सो हियर टू पेयर ऑफ कॉन्ट्रास्टिंग कैरेक्टर्स आर टेकन फॉर द हाइब्रिडाइजेशन प्रोसेस. यस, और इट इज अ क्रॉस बिटवीन टू प्योर, दैट इज ट्रू ब्रीडिंग पेरेंट्स डिफरिंग इन टू पेयर ऑफ कॉन्ट्रास्टिंग कैरेक्टर्स. हियर द पेयर देयर नंबर इज two. Okay, we had already learned about the mono hybrid cross. Mono because we are taking the only one pair of contrasting characters, so that's why mono hybrid. Now here two pair of contrasting characters. Now see why dihybrid cross did by Mendel. Yes, so as Mendel established the principle of dominance and segregation on the basis of mono hybrid crosses. Yes, mono hybrid single pair of contrasting characters, where the principle of dominance, that is whatever the dominant characters are there, it will be shown in the F1 generation. Okay, and segregation, that is the separation of gamete. Okay, so on the basis of mono hybrid crosses. But however, in an organism many characters are present and each is controlled by a pair of alleles. Yes, so as different characters are present in living organisms like ourselves, yes, height, then hair color, eye color, then skin color, these are the different characters are present in our body. Okay, so many characters present and each is controlled by a pair of alleles. Okay, so here does one pair of allele affects or influences the inheritance pattern of other pair of allele. Yes, this is the question. Or each pair is inherited independently as if in monohybrid cross. Okay, so to find out these answers, Mendel performed the dihybrid crosses, that is consider two characters allelic pairs simultaneously and then trihybrid cross. Tri stand for three. Again, he did the trihybrid and then polyhybrid crosses. Okay, now what is dihybrid then? Yes, it is a heterozygous for two triads and produced in a cross between two pure parents differing in two pair of contrasting characters. So hetero stand for different. Okay, so different types of gametes. Okay, for two triads are produced in a cross between two pure parents differing in two pair of contrasting characters. Two pure in the sense of what? They have two triads. Suppose seed color and seed shape. Yes, yellow and round means two pair of contrasting characters. Contrast, here one parent have yellow round and another parent have, yes, green and wrinkled. So they have pure parents which cross together to form a hybrid. Okay, so that is dihybrid, which is in the form of heterozygous. Now see the phenotypic ratio of different types of offsprings, that is with different combinations. Okay, so obtained in the F2 generation of, yes, dihybrid cross is called dihybrid ratio. Okay, so the ratio is 9:3:3:1 in Mendelian crosses. Okay, so ratio, it is according to what the observable characters, like plants with yellow round, yellow wrinkle, green round, green wrinkle, means observable characters. Okay, that is nothing but what the phenotypic ratio in dihybrid cross, and it is fixed, that is all Mendelian crosses, they have the ratio 9:3:3:1 only. Okay, so Mendel performed many dihybrid crosses, okay, with different combinations, and every time he got same result. Okay, same pattern of the ratio of F2 generation. Okay, from this he established the principle of independent assortment. Okay, so then again he followed the same three steps like in monohybrid cross. Yes, which is a classical experimental design that was followed by many breeders after him and discovered different gene interactions. Okay, let's see one by one the steps. Yes, First, that is selection of pure line in the sense of what? Homozygous parents. Okay, so first, that is Mendel selected a variety of pea plants having yellow and round seeds as a female parent, and another that is green and wrinkled seeds as a male parents. Okay, so he obtained pure line by selfing. Okay, he confirmed that yellow round is producing yellow round and green wrinkled is producing green wrinkle for three generations. Okay, so this is the first step in which, yes, for three generations they got the pure line, yes, yellow round and yes, green and wrinkle seeds. Second step is, yes, that is artificial cross. He performed the artificial cross, that is dusted pollen grains from flower of pure male parent on stigma of emasculated flower of female parent. Okay, so that is in due course fruits, that is nothing but what, pods were formed, and he opened all the pods and collected seeds. Okay, so all seeds of F1 generations were yellow and round as expected. Okay, so yellow is dominant over green and round is dominant over wrinkle. Okay, so this is the second step. Third step is, he sowed the seeds and raised the plants of F1 generation and allowed selfing. Okay, so when pods were formed, he opened and collected seeds of F2 generations. He was expecting near about 75% yellow round and 25% green wrinkle seeds. But he was surprised to find that seeds were of four types. That is, F2 generation seeds sowed four different phenotypes. Yes, like yellow round near about 315. Okay, yellow wrinkle 108. And green round 101 and green wrinkle 32, means near about 556 total plants are there, and that is in ratio 9:3:3:1. Okay, so that's why it is called as Mendelian dihybrid ratio. Okay, so here out of four different types, two were parental combinations, means from parents, that is yellow round and green wrinkle, and surprising is that here two were new, that is the recombinations, okay, yellow wrinkle and green round. Mendel performed ample dihybrid crosses, okay, and reciprocal crosses with different combinations. Every time he got same pattern of results, that is uniform expressions, both dominant in F1 generation and in F2 generations. Always he got both dominant in large number, okay, and one dominant and yes, one recessive in less number. Okay, so the other dominant and the first one recessive also equally less, approximately equal, okay, in number, and as well as both recessive were least in number. Thus in all Mendelian dihybrid crosses, the ratio in which four different phenotypes occurred was 9:3:3:1, which is called dihybrid ratio. Now, from the appearance of new combinations in the F2 generations, that is uniform pattern of results of dihybrid cross and dihybrid ratio, Mendel established the principle of independent assortment. Okay, so he performed trihybrid crosses also, and then concluded that when a trihybrid, dihybrid or a polyhybrid forms gametes, okay, each gamete receives only one allele from each pair, okay, due to segregation, separation of gametes, okay, and the assortment, that is distribution of allele of different types, is totally independent one, okay, of their parental combinations. That is, each allele of any one pair of allele is free to enter the gamete with any allele from each of the remaining pairs of alleles. Okay, thus a dihybrid forms four types of gametes due to segregation and independent assortment. Now, to find out all possible genotypes, let us use the Punnett square or checkerboard method for dihybrid cross. Now see in this figure, yes, Mendel started with pure lines. Therefore, genotype of parents with yellow and round seeds is capital YY, capital RR, okay, and that of the parents with green wrinkled seeds is small yy small rr, okay. Both the parents are homozygous, same one, okay. Therefore they would produce only one type of gamete, yes, that is capital Y capital R for yellow round and small y small r for, yes, green wrinkle respectively. All F1 hybrid seeds resulting from the cross will be heterozygous for both the triads and with genotype that is capital Y small y capital R small r. Due to dominance, all the seeds of F1 generation will be yellow and round. Now, Mendel allowed selfing of F1 hybrids during gamete formations by the dihybrid. The allele in both the pairs separate, that is with the help of law of segregation. Each gamete will receive only one allele from each pair, okay. A gamete that receives capital Y for color may receive capital R for shape or small r for shape, okay. This would result in the formation of capital Y capital R and capital Y small r type of gametes, okay. Similarly, a gamete that receives small y, okay, for color may receive capital R or small r for shape. This would result in the formation of, yes, small y capital R and small y small r types of gametes, that is independent assortment. Thus F1 hybrid, that is dihybrid, okay, would produce four different types of gametes in equal proportion, means near about 25%, okay. So there would be four types of male gametes and four types of female gametes, and random fusion will take place during selfing, okay. So due to this chance fusion, 4 into 4 means 16 combinations which fall into 9 categories as shown in Punnett square as possible, okay. The 9 different genotypes are capital YY capital RR, then capital YY capital R small r, then capital Y small y capital RR, then capital Y small y capital R small r, then capital Y small r, yes, then small r, then small y capital R, then small y capital R small r, and finally small y small r, okay. So finally the genotypic ratio is 1:2, 2:4, 1:2, 1:2, 1:1. Due to dominance, there are only 4 phenotypes. The phenotypic ratio is, yes, 9:3:3:1 is called dihybrid ratio, okay. So in phenotypic ratio, there are 9 yellow round seeds, 3 yellow wrinkle seeds and 3 green round seeds and only 1 green wrinkle seeds, okay. So the phenotypic ratio of dihybrid crosses 9:3:3:1, okay. So this is all about dihybrid cross. We will see the genetic disorders in our next lecture, okay. Then bye bye, thank you.